It's not that Mike Myers isn't a comic genius. He clearly is. He just isn't being aimed in the proper direction much of the time, and the Love Guru is the worst proof of this yet. Fresh from the success of launching the modern SNL to movies movement with the smash hit and still justifiable classic Wayne's World, he looked like he'd become a comedy star in the manner of Steve Martin or Robin Williams. But the lukewarm reception of his debut grown-up movie, The Misunderstood So I Married an Axe Murderer, seemed to be a stumbling block that severely altered that course. Since then, he's almost exclusively concentrated in a single area, starring in broad comedies based around absurdist character roles. And let's be clear now, he's good at this. Whatever can be said about the movies surrounding them, Austin Powers, the Guru Pitka, and the like are hilarious, fully formed identities that he vanishes into with tremendous commitment. Oh, that the movies you chose to put them in were always as reliable, and Guru certainly ain't. But it's worth noting that, though the animation and the accent make you forget it, the best roles he's had in the last decade have been his turns as Shrek, and Shrek is the straight man of that series. Seriously, 90% of the jokes go to Donkey and Puss, and Shrek just absorbs, deflects, or reacts. Anyway, Guru Pitka is an American raised in an Indian ashram who's become the world's second most popular self-help guru. His routine and personality are a vicious lampooning of the entirety of Deepak Chopra and the like, and when the film stays on that same track, satirically eviscerating faux Eastern pop spiritual bullshit, it's pretty damn hysterical. Pitka's affection for far-fetched acronyms stating the obvious wisdom and the titles of his obnoxious chicken soup-style books, Comedy Gold. A whole movie on this track would be pretty damn funny, but it'd also end up being several yards smarter and more cutting than the film that was evidently intended to be made here. Instead, the plot has Pitka heading to Canada to help a hockey star patch things up with his wife before the Stanley Cup Finals. The character is a supposed Tiger Woods of hockey, bringing a hip-hop culture infusion to the lily-white sport, and it's a bad sign when we realize that a much funnier movie might probably have been made about him with Pitka in a supporting and thus more concentrated and focused role. Playing as a team owner, and of course, Pitka's love interest, is Jessica Alba. And, you know what? I am so tired of not having anything nice to say about Alba. Sure, she comes off vacant and bland. She hasn't evidenced a shred of actual acting talent or anything resembling a screen presence. And she somehow made a Fantastic Four movie with a neutered, unmasked Dr. Doom suck more just by her being in it. And guys, she's not really as hot as you think she is, okay? So instead, let me just be nice and say thank you, Mrs. Alba, for at the very least not cutting an album yet, to my knowledge. John Oliver, Stephen Colbert, Jim Gaffigan, and Ben Kingsley also show up to waste their time, and Vern Troyer is on hand for another round of bad short jokes. Just about the only one not embarrassing themselves is Justin Timberlake, who, ah man, I wish he'd go back to sucking, you know? I hate being wrong about people. I hated NSYNC as much as every other nominally heterosexual man on the planet. But as a solo artist, yeah, Timberlake's got some chops. It's not really my musical taste, but I know when it's good. And yeah, he's a damn good actor, turns out, and both this and his SNL turns show that he's got a real knack for humor. So actor, singer, dancer, funny man, chicks dig him, total package. A born star. God damn it. The jokes aren't funny, the characters aren't memorable, the story is non-existent, and there's not a single interesting gag or shot in the whole fucking production. It's an utter waste of resources, theoretically valuable only if it can serve as a signal to Myers to stop blowing his time and effort on this shit. As it stands now, it's likely the worst film of his career, and easily one of the low points of the 2008 movie season.